Hello students, today we are going to learn a new story from lesson number 32, The Noble Stag. This story is about the king of Banaras and the noble stag. Stag means a male deer. As we all know, King Brahmadatta of Banaras was extremely fond of hunting. Luckily for him, on the outskirts of the city was a huge forest filled with deer. Among them, there was a mighty stag. Outskirt means the outer part of a city or town. Students, the king named Brahmadatta of Banaras. You know the Banaras city is famous for Banarasi sari and also famous for Ganga river. So the king was belong from Banaras and he was fond of hunting. And luckily in the outskirts means in his kingdom outside the city there was a huge forest filled with deer and many other animals. On fine day the king had gone hunting with his courtiers. He told his courtiers, "If you allow even a single deer to escape, I will punish you severely." So the courtiers formed a tight circle from which no deer could escape. So one day the king went for hunting with his courtiers. Courtiers means person at the court of a king. And he strictly told the courtiers that if even a single deer escape, he will punish them severely. So the courtiers form a tight circle so not a single deer could escape from their covered area. Then they began to beat their sticks on the ground to frighten the deer hiding in the bushes and to make them run. The only way out of their circle was through a small clearing where the king stood ready with his bow and arrows. The courtiers were beating their sticks on the ground and shouting when suddenly a stag leaped out of a thicket. Thicket means thick growth of shrubs and plants. So students, all the courtiers started beating their sticks on the ground and started making noise through which the stag or a deer who are hiding behind the bushes will come out. And suddenly one stag leaped out of a thicket, leaped out of the shrubs. means jump out of the shrubs. The stag saw that the king was standing in the way. So he looked the king straight in the eye and made a dash towards him. The king was taken aback and shot an arrow towards the stag hurriedly. Of course, it missed the mark, but the stag rolled over. Students, yes, when the stag came out of the bushes, he saw that the king was standing in the way. So he looked straight in the eye of the king, and king took aback to shoot an arrow towards the stag. When he shot an arrow, the mark was missed. Then also the stag rolled over as if he was shot by the arrow. Now there is one thing that you must know about the stag. It has excellent instincts and is extremely good at dodging arrows, whether shot at from the back, front, or even the top. If an arrow is aimed at its belly, it pretends to roll over and then jumps up and runs once the danger has passed. So students, you must know that stags are very good in dodging arrows. They pretend to roll over when it is danger, and at once the danger is passed, they runs away. So when this stag rolled over, the king thought that his arrow had found its mark. He lowered his bow and began to walk towards the stag. But the stag suddenly jumped up and shot past the man. When the courtiers realized that the king had been mistaken, they started to laugh. So students, when the stag rolled up, the king thought that his arrow had marked to the stag. So he lowered his bow, means he put his bow down and began to walk towards the stag. But suddenly the stag jumped up and ran away. Looking this, the courtiers realized that the king had been mistaken. So they began to laugh at the king. Now the king thought himself to be an excellent marksman and could not bear the taunts of his men. He grabbed his sword and set off into the forest in order to catch the stag. He chased the stag for quite a while and covered a long distance students. Now the king was thinking about himself that he was an excellent marksman, but when he failed his courtiers started laughing, and looking that he became angry, and angrily he grabbed the sword and set off and started running behind the stag. And while he was running, he covered a long distance and he kept his courtiers behind, and he was just running behind the deer to catch it. Taunts means teasing or insulting remarks. Marksman means a person skilled in shooting, in hunting, or in hitting a target. The stag came upon a hole in the ground that was covered by a rotting tree and filled with slime. From a distance, it could smell the dirty water and so was careful not to run over it. But the king could not sense the pit and fell right into it. So students, when stag was running, he came upon a hole in the ground and it was covered with rotting leaves and dirty water was there inside. Slime means an unpleasantly thick and slippery liquid substance which was smelling bad. It was dirty water. So the stag came to know that here it is pit over here, and so he ran from the distance so he could not fall into the pit. But the king could not sense the pit is over here and he fell into the pit. After a while, the stag realized that it was not being followed any longer. He understood that the king had perhaps fallen into the pit. So the stag was running and he realized that no one is following him. So he understood that the king may be fallen into the pit. Pit means a large hole in the ground. So the stag went back to the pit and saw the king struggling for his life. The stag felt very sorry for the king. He decided to save the king's life, even though the king was following him with the intention to kill him. So students, when the stag came back and saw that king is fallen into the pit and he was struggling to save his life, looking this, stag felt very sorry for the king and he decided to save the king's life even though king was following him to kill the stag. The stag told the king not to worry and to be brave for a while longer. He then caught a huge rock with his hind legs and lowered himself into the pit. The king caught hold of his neck and the stag climbed out onto the level ground and carried the king to safety. So, student, stag helped the king to come out of the pit. The king thanked the noble stag again and again and asked him to return with him to Banaras, where he could have anything and everything he wanted. But the stag did not want anything in return for his help. So, after king got out of the pit, he realized that this stag is so noble, so helpful, and that's why the king thanks to that stag again and again and asked the stag to come to Banaras in his kingdom. But stag was not willing to take anything in return for his help. He just requested the king to rule wisely and well and be kind to animals. Then the noble stag disappeared into the forest. King Brahmadatta then vowed not to hunt or hurt any animals. So, the stag requested the king to rule wisely and well and not to hurt any animal. Be kind to every animals and disappeared in the forest. After that, King Brahmadatta promised that not to hunt or not to hurt any animals. So, students, you must have enjoyed this story. Thank you.